Set Radio Show, HipHopHighlights.com. We got battle rapper.
Shut the fuck up.
We got battle rapper Leroy Reynolds.
That's how you gonna start the show?
Wow.
Baldish.
Great. Atlanta Falcons. Number one linebacker in the league. I don't know yet, though. Leroy Reynolds, what's up, baby?
Murder. It's good.
That's how we gonna start it? That's how we gonna start it?
Murder Mac.
Yeah, I'm letting everybody know.
Hey, that's fucked up,
from
man.
Jump.
You know, I just wanna be Malcolm. You know what I mean?
Murder.
I just wanna be Malcolm on the set radio shit,
you
man. Congratulations on everything that's going down with you, man.
Appreciate it.
I'm sure it's been like a long journey, though. What number team you on right now, brother?
Third.
Where are you with right now?
Atlanta Falcons.
Where, man? How that journey been so far, man? This will be your first season with them, right?
Yeah.
Where are you excited?
Yeah, man. It's a good opportunity. You know what I mean? We got great coaches. I think it's going to be, you know what I mean, great team. Guys excited to be there. You feel me? And it's different. It's different. It's a different feel than where I've been before, like Jacksonville and Chicago. But, you know what I mean? I'm just happy to be there.
For sure, man. You know, I tell you all the time, man. You know, I never watched football, man. It's got to be all the way 100, you know what I mean?
You're just a quarterback. You're a quarterback.
Yeah, I could have been a quarterback.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, real talk.
Really.
For more. I always tell niggas, if I went no more and played football, we'd have went to state, sir. Yeah.
I believe that.
Oh. Mount was so sorry.
Hey, look, we used to play football in the neighborhood. Never played.
What's wrong with y'all niggas, man?
It's not my lane. You know, niggas try to act like it. Huh? Get out there and play. No. Then them niggas be weak. Me? I'm good. I know me, bro. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Come on, Mount. Nah. Come on. Fuck that. But, look, man, high school, we used to just get fly, man. You know, you high school, right? You get your little check, man. I used to work at the shoe store at Champs. Used to work at Man Alive.
So,
so I used to take my paycheck, man, buy me, like, well fit to school, then buy a fit for the game, but not really pay attention to the game, though, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't really into football. So, you know, at work, they talk about football all the time. So when they ask me what was my favorite team at the time, I mean, it was Jacksonville, you know what I'm saying? Because that's who my man played for, right, you feel right, me? That's just how I go.
Now it's the Falcons.
Right now, my team, the Falcons, you feel me? That's just who, you know what I mean? What's one of the biggest differences for you, man? Like, because you're definitely from Norfolk City, man, born and raised. So what's one of the biggest adjustments, man, from being in high school and then, you know, you playing on that college level to actually playing on the NFL level at this point?
Oh, man. Just like realizing, you know, the business side of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in high school is football, college is football, but you know what I mean, NFL is a business.
Right.
You know, it's a corporation, it's run, you know what I mean? But you got owners. And I think that side of the game, aside from football, is like having just a job, like, you know what I mean?
Right.
And within that, you know, guys lose their job, guys get hired every day.
For sure.
So it's just like understanding like that part of it and really knowing how to manage that money,
right,
and be a part of something that can, you know what I mean, grow in that. You know what I mean? In high school and college, you don't really think about, you know what I mean, financially what you can do.
Right.
I mean, with football, but you know what I mean, when you within that business, you got to understand what you need to do.
I mean, speaking on like the whole business side, man, you only been in the what, drafted 2013.
Right.
We here 2016, man. So what actually happens, cuz at first it was Jacksonville.
Mm-hmm.
And then we was with Chicago,
right,
for a very short amount of time.
So you and my now story? Or you just wanna?
Nah. Okay, listen, like, man. Listen, you know I do enough research, man. Make sure we know what we talk about up here. But like, what? I'm not, like I said, for the most part, this gonna probably be like a combo for real, cause I'm educating myself as well.
Right.
So like, what happens? Cause you speak about the business side. So what happens from like, you know, you at Jacksonville, and then the Chicago things happen. I mean, situation happening now. You in Atlanta, like what actually caused the movement
in
such a short amount of time?
Right. Well, when I was in Jacksonville last year, during training camp, like the second game of training camp,
mm-hmm,
a preseason game, I got hurt.
Okay.
Sprained my MCL. Came back beginning of the season. I had like a grade 2 MCL. Usually guys will sit out. I had a brace on. I told him to put me back out there. Just because I knew the severity of the situation, I knew I was going to have to get back out there.
Right, you know what I mean? It don't really seem like you scared of injury, man. You chasing niggas with a helmet on.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just the dog.
Seen that shit. I said, this nigga crazy, dude. I done took a knee on niggas.
No, you know what I'm saying? I couldn't.
But yeah.
But after I got hurt, you know, a lot of guys on the team like, yeah, you will get picked up, you'll get picked up, you know, because I got released.
Right.
I got released like after the third game.
Wow. And this is from?
Jacksonville.
Okay.
Yeah, so basically, like, I'm chilling in the locker on Friday.
Right.
Before the game, they come in, be like, look, we got to talk to you. None of the coaches knew. Nobody really knew, like, what was going to happen.
Right.
I mean, it came from, like, a higher up, like the scouts and the GMs and such like that. Mm-hmm. And the thing is, like, with certain guys, they'll, like, release a guy and bring him back on Monday, and that's usually just for numbers. Like, right. You know what I mean? If you're not going to play this week, then we'll just release you on a Friday, bring you back on a Monday. Mm-hmm. Cool. So they released me with the plans to bring me back Monday. You know, most of the guys are like, you know, right. Probably ain't going to be back. Because, I mean, for me, it's like, I know what I can do. And on special teams, like in the league, a lot of coaches around the league, you know what I mean, that's what they know me as, like a special team dog.
Right.
Like,
right.
So a lot of guys was like, well, you know, my special team coach, me and him had a good, like heart to heart when I left, because nobody knew what was going to happen. So anyways, I had to actually sign back with Jacksonville like mm-hmm. that Monday, because nobody picked me up.
Right.
From everybody talking about, oh, you can get picked up, you're going, mm-hmm. like, nobody picked me up. So it really set in. Like,
that's all I'm about to say, man.
This shit real.
At that moment, though, yeah, like, how do you feel, though? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, for me, it wasn't like I was, I wouldn't say, I wasn't nervous, mm-hmm. but I just knew. I mean, you know what I mean? My faith was so strong. I mean, I made it this far.
For sure.
Like, if it was over,
right?
I knew I did everything I had to do.
But you know what, though, man?
You know what I mean?
And quote me if I'm wrong, right. You know what I'm saying? That's what we're here for. You got signed as an undrafted free agent.
Undrafted. Yeah.
You know, with that being said, man, I know, like, I mean, because you know, we knew,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Especially, I'm sure Flood knew, Mike Tice, we knew I did just from growing up,
right?
You know what I'm saying? How much you was doing this thing, man, like, we all knew you was good, but like, even then, though, like, when the draft coming, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? We all sitting at home watching the draft.
Right.
And we don't see Roy, we just like, damn, like,
yeah.
But then, last minute, we see that Instagram pic, you know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah, so nah,
like,
it's
always
tough.
For you, it,
it
just
tough.
Seemed like, man, you keep your faith high, man, you
got
know
to.
What I'm saying? Like, it's
got
almost
to.
Like, you know,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, while
without
we here sweating, it's like, you know, though.
Yeah, without a doubt.
You know what I'm
only
saying?
Only because, you know what I mean, it was given to me a
right,
long
for
time
sure.
ago, like, you know what I mean?
Right.
So it's just a gift. You know what I mean? I'm able to do something I love to do.
Definitely,
so,
man.
But, you know what I mean? After Chicago, like, Chicago called me actually late that night, like 10 o'clock.
Wow.
Because I ain't hit nothing all day. So I signed back with Jacksonville.
Mm-hmm.
Chicago called me 10 o'clock at night. My agent hit me like, yo, Chicago trying to sign you.
Right.
I'm like, word. So 10 o'clock that night, I talked to the GM. He said, listen, we want you to come here and play next week. Mm. Mind you, I'm still here. I got a brace on.
Right,
you know what
right.
I mean? I'm like, bet, I'm out of here.
Yeah, man, right.
they say your flight tomorrow at 6 a.m. My whole crib in Jacksonville, everything was there. I left everything. I packed the bag
right.
and got on the flight. That was it. Like, I was gone. And me, you see how me shit happened so fast?
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? Your life changed that fast. I'm
definitely.
In a whole new city, like a whole new atmosphere. Everything changed like
right.
that fast. But, you know what I mean? It was all meant to, you know what I mean, happen that
for
way.
For sure, man.
But then, yeah, I got picked up.
Well, so we at
transition to Atlanta.
But hold on, before that, we at Chicago.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what happened with Chicago? How did you go from Chicago to Atlanta?
Oh, Chicago was cool, man.
Did you get on the field with Chicago?
Yeah. Which was good.
Right.
Because it was honestly, and you gotta understand the league. It's, you know, it's a profession.
For sure.
And everybody's good.
That's
like,
what I mean.
Everybody is.
We be
good.
Talking about that, man. Like,
you know
when you
mean?
Go to the league, you know, you in college and high school,
right.
You that nigga.
Right.
You know what
right.
I'm saying? But when you in the league,
everybody
you in the league with every nigga
everybody.
Who was every nigga in the league
every,
was that nigga.
Yeah, but not
my nigga, 90%, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
a lot of them.
About 85%.
Was that nigga 80, at their high school or their college? You
about
feel 85%, me? So,
yeah. You got a good. And then you got, like, you got the elite players, you
right.
know what I mean? And you got good, great players, you got good players. You got like a mix of, you know what I mean? You got special teamers,
sure.
guys that's gonna make the team. You know what I mean? Rookie, young guys.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, anyways, for me, I think it was like it was a confidence builder. Mm. Like just knowing like, oh, I can do this. This is easy.
Right.
I can play in this league.
For sure.
You know what I mean? So they gave me the opt to play. Like I played like 3 games. I did my thing.
I mean, this is all after you healed and.
For the most part, I mean, I stopped wearing my brace. Like I probably stopped wearing my brace like the second game.
Right.
So I stopped wearing my brace or whatever. Then I had a really, you know what I mean, a solid game against Detroit. Mm. Next week we played Minnesota. You know what I mean? They didn't shake out too well.
Right.
You know what I mean? It was just. I made it too big, you feel me? Adrian Peterson. Like, I'm in my head. I'm like, okay, yeah. I got to get right. Like,
right.
You know what I mean? And I should have just played like I always played.
For sure.
But, you know what I mean? At the same time,
learning
it was a good learning experience.
Right.
Like, and then, you know what I mean? For me, hitting Adrian Peterson.
Yeah.
Like, meeting that man in the hole and stopping this man tracks.
Right.
I was like, oh, this is easy.
Yeah.
I can do this.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, that's why I say it was meant to happen because I needed that confidence boost coming into this year.
Right.
That's why everything happened the way it's supposed
for
to.
For sure, man.
So, I mean, things didn't really pan out the way it did in Chicago just for more so personal reasons.
Right.
I think that it started off really well. But just with so much outside of football that was happening.
Right.
It kinda, you know what I mean?
Right.
It took me to a place where I ain't never been, but it helped me grow.
But see, that's my question though,
right.
Man, because like, you know, again, man, I always gotta like really like I always gotta place things on where we from.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's like this big stigma on where we from, man, as far as athletes, rappers is concerned, talent just in general. So with going to, hey, you listening to the show?
No, we at the Jazz
Festival. All right, we out, bye. Don't worry about it. We live on air right now. I just had to call you, make sure you see if you was listening to the show. You can edit out the footage, so don't worry about it. Alright, we gone.
Shit,
huh? Nah, we gone. I'm interviewing Roy. We gone.
Hey, Roy.
What's good?
Alright, yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. Hey, right.
Hey, Miss Yolanda.
Yeah. Yeah, she crazy. I just seen her.
Yeah, we gone though.
Okay, love y'all.
All right. The auto program with them asses.
Nah, but, so look, right? So like, you know, based on where we from,
right,
what be going on, and then you, right? So, you know, you get in the league.
Uh-huh.
Well, first, you know, of course, we were scared at first, you know, from like, dang, man, where Roy at? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And last minute, we see Jacksonville, you know what I'm saying? Jacksonville happened. You ended up getting hurt. You go to Chicago.
Yeah.
That particular situation changed to where you at now. Like, in any given time, though, you could have just been like, you know what? I did go to school. I can just go out here and I can try to do this and be okay. Like, what's the motivation, though? Like, what gets you up every morning? Like, you know what, man? Even though this, that, and the third happened, I'm here. You know what I'm saying? We're going to make it work.
Oh, man. I love this shit, man.
Word,
that's
man.
It.
Word, man.
That's
like,
it.
You know what I mean? At the end of the day, when you love something,
yeah.
Like you know it's in your heart to love it, you wake up every day and you do what you love to do.
For sure, man.
You know what I mean? Don't get me wrong. It's not, every day is not, it's great, it's great, it's
oh,
great.
Listen,
great.
Bro, you know but we had them talks.
Love,
man,
you feel
for
me?
Sure.
That's love. Love ain't never always gonna be a clean slate. Like this how it's always, you know what I mean? Always is. But, you know what I mean? So for me, honestly, bro, it's just, by the grace of God, man, and just being able to do something I love to do.
It's like just a blessing to be
that's
there.
It. Like, I can't really, and I ain't never lose faith.
Right.
Like, and that's the thing, like, for what?
And you know, one of the other things that I be noticing too, man, is that like, as far as giving back, man, you know
yeah.
what I'm saying? Like,
because
we got a lot of people from here.
Right.
Now, let's be clear. You don't have to give back.
Right.
You don't. It's no well written where you gotta give back. You gotta show love where you from. You know, you don't have to do that. Some people may expect you to,
right.
but you don't have to.
Right.
You know, that's something that you take out of your own day and you make happen. Like, man, I was watching, I seen that you had did the, in Suffolk, man.
Where oh, yeah, doing yeah, Habitat for Humanity.
Yeah, yeah, like how did that whole thing come about and what actually puts you in a place where you felt like, you know what, this is what I'm gonna do right here.
Well, that came about, somebody from my church actually, you know, brought it up and, you know, we coordinated it
right.
with with some people in the city. Okay. The Habitat for Humanity, they basically, they rebuild certain houses for certain families, right, who, you know, who really need it. So for me, that was a good opportunity just to get out there, do something positive.
Definitely.
I mean, be a part of something. Man, I love Norfolk. You know what I mean?
For sure, man.
And like that's it. So right, it ain't nothing to give back. It ain't nothing to go talk to the little kids and be like, this what happened in my life. Hey, look. So I'm gonna explain this to you.
That's when you do this right here, Flood.
And so when we come back to you.
Yeah.
Oh, like, full circle. It. That's how like, the universe works. Man, right.
It's for them.
Right.
I ain't losing that.
For sure.
You know
man.
What I mean?
That's when you throw that in right there. So when we go do that that Mountain Roy.
I'm waiting for
Norfolk, at Norfolk City Festival, man.
I'm waiting for out. I'm when trying to do something.
Know what I'm saying? When we go do something, you
I'm
feel me?
I'm trying to do something big.
But no, I think that's dope, man. You know what though, man? It was so crazy. I was watching the joint, man, when you actually went back to the library. And one of the kids was talking, man. I just thought it was so dope. The kid said, contracts is important. You know what I'm saying? Because when you read them contracts, you got to know what you're getting yourself into. You know what I'm saying? 10 years old. You know what I'm saying? Right. And I just thought that was dope, man. That you was actually able to go back, you know, sit there. You know what I'm saying? Talk to the kids. Yeah. You know, sign autographs. You know what I'm saying?
That's because, like, want.
Because, and one thing I wanted to ask you about, too, man, because, like, you know, speaking of the kids, it's like,
yeah,
as long as I've known you, man, you know, you always been a student first. When it came to like being a student athlete, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of kids like growing up, even for myself, like growing up, I just used to like really like basketball, but I never was into like, what is it that I would have to do to be on that level right, if I wanted to be in the NBA one day or whatever. Yeah, yeah. You know, I could still be in the league, Roy.
Who lead?
Next question.
They play Sunday after they park.
Next question.
That league? What you talking about? Matt can be in the
league. I'm the best one guy.
I'll run down the hoop and Lama Point one time. On some shacks. Almost broke his head.
Stop it, man. But how important is it, man, to give that knowledge, man, or to show the children, man, that, you know, before you want to be able to do, because again, people may look at it like, okay, you good, right, then you can make it, you know what I'm saying? But it's other things that factor into that, you right, know what I'm saying? How important was it for you, man, to of course, you know, keep your skill together, but also make sure that you excel as a student as well, right, through high school, college, you know what I'm saying?
I think for me, it's just I knew who I was,
right,
and you know what I mean, being from the city, you see a lot of people, great athletes, really, really. I'm talking about from middle school,
bro. We can name some
grade,
of the greatest ones from the neighborhood.
Like,
you feel me?
From
like,
the neighborhood itself, from Lama's Point.
Yes,
I ain't talking. That's one little neighborhood.
And if they just would have been the student part,
and for me, it was like, if I play, if I don't do what I gotta do, I can't do what I love to do.
Ooh, word.
You know what I mean?
Hold on, Roy. One more time, man. Let's put that in the next Say that one more time.
If I don't do what I gotta do, I can't do what I love to do.
Word.
And that was football. So I knew, all right, I gotta excel in the classroom, you know what I mean, off the field, and then excel in football. They coincide.
Right.
Like, you can't do one without the other.
For sure.
There's so many athletes out here, young boys, and I just wish they got it. Like, listen, that's first. Even if you don't like going to class, you just gotta do it.
Right.
Because you love football.
Right.
Because
at
the end of the day, school ain't gonna last, but this feeling, that feeling gonna last forever.
For sure.
You know what I mean? You always gonna love the game.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's like, whatever you love to do, you gotta sacrifice. So for me, it was just like, I knew what I had to do.
Right.
School, that was it. Go
but
to class,
I mean, but
do work.
Even with that, man, like, even with that, man, so like, I mean, and again, man, I look at it like that's a lot, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because like, again, like I was telling you before, in the NFL, NBA, MLB, whatever you do, right? At one point in time, again, like we talking about, 85% of them was the man at their school, right? So being the man at your school, juggling schoolwork, making sure that you on top of your skill set and dealing.
Atlanta.
You know what I'm saying?
Atlanta,
man.
Good transition.
Definitely, man. So you want to speak about how that whole thing came about?
Oh yeah, for sure. Off season rolled around.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't sign back with Chicago, so I was a free agent.
Right.
Cool. I'm talking to my agent. you know, he busy. He got a lot of other players that he need to coordinate contracts for and do all that for. So, you know what I mean? I know my position, so I'm just sitting back waiting for him to say the word. I'm getting a little antsy. I'm trying to figure out what's really going on. Like, you know what I mean? He told me a certain date. That date kind of passed. I was like, what's happening? I ain't got a job yet. Like, so, you know, a couple teams were interested. You know, Seattle, Buffalo, a couple teams that he just mentioned.
Little humble brag.
No, they show interest, but you know, it's a competitive league. Like everybody want a certain type of player. They want a certain, you know, they want what they want.
Right.
So for me, I just had to play the waiting game. I waited it out. He told me, so like the last minute, maybe like a week and a half later, he was like, yo, Atlanta really thinking about signing you. We just gonna wait it out and see what they wanna do. Cool. Bet. I hit up everybody I knew that had contacts in Atlanta. I hit up all my coaches from Jacksonville. I hit up my head coach, my linebacker coach, because the coaches from Jacksonville coach with the coaches in Atlanta and Seattle. Like, so it's basically like a pipeline, you know what I mean? And my special teams coach, his brother is a coach for Atlanta as well. And it was just basically like I reached out to all of them. I need y'all to hit up the coaches in Atlanta, talk to them for me, put in a good word. They hit me back immediately.
Oh, so you got a great rapport with the coaches that you used to be on the team with.
And then my homie played for the Broncos, Brandon Marshall. His linebacker coach is my D coordinator now. So I hit him. You know what I mean? They talk for like an hour. I get the call the next day. Pull up. They was like, man, we had so many people vouching for you. We had to sign you. But you know what I mean? Yeah, and it was just.
That's dope.
That's just what it was.
That's like, dope, though, man.
I'm pretty sure, you know what I mean? The universe just came together. Like, it's supposed to be that way.
Man, right.
You know what I mean?
I like the story.
Listen,
man, I'm going to be tuned in, man. You know what I'm saying?
You got to.
I got to be, man. I want to see. You know what I mean? Of course, I was tuned in when you was.
I'm in the A now, so you really got to, like, it's the A. You know what I mean?
That's what's up, man. I mean, how does it feel, though, man? Because I know, like, I was just talking to Av, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, Av from the city, you know, Av doing URL now, traveling. You know, with you, man, like, you can, you from Lammas Point, Morey High School. We used to go to the parties. I was a little OD, like, bring your ass, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, how does it feel, though, like, when you wake up early? Like, how does it feel? I know it's surreal, though, man, like, just to be traveling the way you do. Like, you know, how does it feel, like, when you get, when you are able to come home when you do? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man, I'm just grateful, bro. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you got to think about a time where I done seen a lot of my homies leave. You feel me? Prison or get killed. Like,
for sure.
So for me, I'm just grateful. Like, so when I come home, like, it's just.
I was with you that night, man.
You know what I mean?
That was real, man.
Like, it's just a surreal feeling just to be able to say that I'm here in this position to do something like this.
Yeah, how was it, you know what I mean? Because, you know, man, rest in peace, man. Charles, man. Humphreys, man. Big rest in peace to him, man.
Salute to the sergeant.
For sure, salute, man. You know, and you know, speaking to him, man, another person, man, that was great, man. Both sports, you know what I'm saying? And you know, I get on Instagram a lot, man, and I see you pay homage a lot, man. Like,
got to.
How was y'all relationship, and how did his passing play a role on like how you how what you doing or what motivated you based on, you know, his passing? You know what I'm saying?
Man, I remember in eighth grade, Charles played for the Crusaders. I played for the Dukes. Mind you, we both undefeated. So in middle school, you get to talk shit a little bit. You walk in, you with your jersey on. Lammas Point versus Park Place. That's just what it was. So, you know what I mean? I see Charles in the hallway.
If you didn't know, man, we from Norfolk, Virginia. All my listeners out there.
Norfolk, VA,
you know what
man.
I'm saying?
Hey, look, so I see Charles in the hallway. We talking shit like, nigga, we gonna kill y'all niggas, whatever. So we go to the game. These niggas come out there. We the Park Place Crusaders. Live. I'm talking about 100 miles away. We hear these boys. So we out there live. So, you know what I mean? We end up winning the game. I got a good little smack on him in the backfield. You know what I mean? It was mutual, though. We ain't really, he ain't go backwards. I ain't go forward. We just kind of fell. Like, so I was new. It was respect. You know what I mean? Eighth grade came around. we played Black basketball together.
Yeah.
And
I played for Black.
Good. I played.
Right, right. They probably was sorry. But our eighth grade year, like it was me, Charles, London, O, Bro Chop, like
RPO, man.
And like, mind you, bro, like these is just, you know what I mean? Like two neighborhoods just together, like and for us, like we was really good that year. Like undefeated. Like then we went to ninth grade JV football, we undefeated. So like our relationships was just building, and then Charles really took off like his sophomore year.
Yeah.
Like at running back, you know what I mean?
Right.
So and I was playing varsity. He was still playing JV, but he was really like he was nice.
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
and he knew he should have been playing varsity, but at the same time, he just had to hold it down on JV. But man, we just playing together
for
all those years.
And I'm sure and building that relationship the potential too, man, that he had.
Yeah, that's it. Like and it was just a respect. Like it was one person that, you know what I mean, senior year, cause I was a hothead. If it was one person that I won't go try, we probably Charles.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
Right, just won't.
No, like his last game though, like basketball.
Yeah.
First half of the game, he dropped 19.
Yeah.
Like, the last game he played, I still remember. Like I remember watching the film.
No, look, man, it's so crazy, man. We used to have weight training together.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So like, in between that time, we used to go to class or whatever. Like Charles is the only nigga smoke two cigarettes in the bathroom. come to weight training and bust herb out of ass.
Yeah, he's real.
You know what I'm saying? Like just natural talent, though. You know what I'm saying?
So, but yeah. I mean,
it's dope, man.
And it's crazy because honestly, but the day it happened, I took bro home that morning.
Word.
Like we left basketball practice. I took bro home. You know what I mean?
We was at what's the club?
Mount, you called me to the club.
Yeah,
we at the club. Mount was like, I lead a Wayne concert.
Yeah.
Mount was like, hey man, come to the club.
Yeah.
And
what was the shit down Waterside? Not 333.
Yeah, what that shit?
Because 333 was on the
little team. Yeah, you had to go upstairs.
I forgot what it was called, Waterside, but I forgot what the club was called. It won't 333 though.
Right.
It was called something else.
I know what you talking about.
Forgot, man. I had on this ugly ass blue and
we was in there though. Like I'm just vibing. I just lead a concert. We vibing. I get a phone call from Valerie.
Yeah,
I'm like, why you called me out of all people? Like, she called me first. I'm the first nigga like she called.
Yeah.
She's like, Roy, you need to come out here like ASAP. I just killed Lil Charles. I'm like, what?
Crazy, man.
You know what I mean?
So speaking, you know, I ain't trying to, I don't want to get too deep, you know what I'm saying? But speaking of that, man, you know, it's a lot going on right now.
Yeah,
man. Whole lot, man. I always have my own opinion on things. I'm sure everybody in here will have their own opinion about a lot of things that's going on. But, you know, I seen you post on Instagram the other day. I guess it was the 23 reasons that you will get killed as a black man or whatever the case may be, man. And it's a lot going on, man, you know. And it's to the point now where it's getting so crazy. We're like, we actually witnessing these things on camera. Like, we watching it happen. And then we watch these police officers go home to their family every night. You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy, man. Like, what's your take on everything that's going on, man? Because I seen you post about it, so I thought I'd you know, ask you what's your take on it.
So the other day we had this camp, right? Talking to the little kids, basically doing like this life skills,
right.
You know what I mean, thing. We got police officers there, and it's like me, Cam, guy I played with in college, a couple other guys in
the Cam, come to the show, baby.
And we having like a little, open discussion, basically. Yeah. Everybody having a good time.
Right.
It's my turn to speak, so I told them the real.
Word.
You know what I mean? Just cause, like, you in a room full of all these kids, 15, 16, 17.
Right.
Probably younger than that, and they black.
They black.
Like, you need to understand the severity. They don't really understand what's going on right now. But being 25, I know what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I know the fear.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? It can happen to any of us.
Yeah.
Any of one of my homies.
For sure.
Church off in these streets.
Right.
Yeah,
like,
man,
and for me, it's just like, seeing it so much,
right?
It's like, you know what I mean. It's tough.
It's tough.
But you know what I mean. It's always trying to find a way. How can we fix the situation?
Man, it's so crazy, man. I got pulled over, man. I was coming from North Carolina. It was like 3 a.m. You know what I'm saying? So I had a rental. So I'm, you know, if you're familiar with the Virginia area, Chesapeake. A battlefield, you know, that's where the state troopers be at.
Out there.
But it's like 3 a.m, I'm coming right from North Carolina, I ain't thinking about it. I got a rental. You know what I mean? I'm goddamn gone. You feel me? Like I'm doing like 87.
Right.
But before I'm tired, you know what I mean? Before I could even slow down when I seen him.
Woo-woo.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? Behind me. So Listen, bro, for me, I can't speak with nobody else, but for me, it was so scary because of everything that was going on. Police officer was behind me for maybe a good 15, 20 minutes before I pulled over because I refused to pull over. 3 a.m, dark, on the interstate. Yeah. Bro, we got off the exit and found a Waffle House. You understand me? I made sure that where I got pulled over at, it was a couple people outside in a lit area. Yeah. You shoot me, you gonna shoot me in front of everybody, you feel me? Somebody gonna see this. And it was so crazy, he pulled me over and he was like, do you have your license and registration? I still had on my wedding clothes, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, yeah, so he took it from me. He said, you know, why were you going? He said, what took you so long to pull over? And I was like, I gotta be honest with you, it's a lot going on with y'all these days, you know what I'm saying? And I just wanted to make sure that wherever I pulled over, it was some people. So the officer really said, you know what? I understand that. I'm gonna run your license and I'll be back. You know what I'm saying? Came back to the car and was like, listen, you got a plus five driving record. You got a plus five driving record, that's a little humble brag. Get home safe. You know what I'm saying? And what made me feel like that he ain't give me no ticket was because I just kept it 100 with him. I just was like, listen, man, you know, it's a lot going on with y'all these days. And he really was just like, I understand it. But I say that to say that, like, it shouldn't have to be that way, though.
Like, I mean, I'm telling, like,
we should trust the people
that's supposed to
be protecting us. You know what I'm saying?
It's been this way.
It has been this way.
These situations ain't new.
For sure.
Technology, cameras are new.
That's what I'm thinking. It's like, you know what I'm saying?
How they did all that. That shit wasn't brought to no light. For ain't nobody, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
That's some crazy shit.
Jack
Daniels
throw us a check.
Yeah. What's crazy is though, while we had the little thing the other day, mm-hmm. after I finished, you know what I mean, speaking or whatever,
right.
Like 3-4 police officers came up to me. One, she came up to me, gave me a hug, apologized to me.
Wow.
She said, I'm sorry. Right. Like, you know what I mean? Just
for
like,
sure.
Just cause she knew.
Because it ain't all bad cops.
Right.
Like every police officer.
It ain't.
Of course. But what did you say to the, you know what I'm saying? You never said what you said to the kids.
Just basically. For me, I just had to kind of paint a picture of, you know what I mean, what's really going on, because they probably don't see it.
Right,
like, even
right.
though they on social media, they
of course.
They probably not really, they don't really feel the effects of it.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I think being at this age I'm at, I feel like I feel the effects a little more. Mm-hmm. So if I can tell them, like, this is what's really happening.
Right.
This is how it's happening. Mm-hmm. Like, they may not understand it. Mm-hmm. Like, when I was younger, I probably didn't understand certain
right,
stuff.
Right,
you know
sure,
what I mean?
Man,
so, if somebody's, like, honestly, bro, I'll tell you, the room went silent.
Mm-hmm.
I probably talked for, like, 5-10 minutes. Just
right,
like,
right, right.
Just I want y'all to really understand this. Like, there's a target.
Yeah.
There's a target. Unfortunately.
Right.
Yeah.
But it's systematic. You know what I mean? It's systematic. It ain't all police officers, but within this system that... It's set up for us to be, you know what I mean, targeted because the way we view.
Well, for you, man, is
right.
it because I hear people say stuff like, man, it ain't just black lives matter. It's all lives matter. And anybody that want to chime in can, because I know this, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So what is it for you?
Right.
And then I can give you, you know what
I've
I mean?
I've seen this analogy on Instagram, and maybe this isn't a good analogy to kind of. When there's a house on fires,
mm-hmm.
that's where the fire department goes to.
Right.
All houses matter,
right.
but there's a certain house that's on fire right now.
Right.
And that house happens to be black men, young
Preach,
black
bro.
In America.
Preach.
You know what I mean? And it's just interesting to see, like, they wanna, it's the media,
sure,
you know what I mean?
For sure.
It's a big thing, and we get so, we really don't see the,
Everything.
You know what I mean? We see what they want us to see.
For sure.
Right. So don't get me
wrong.
We all do matter, but at the end of the day, this is what's
going on.
Because from the inception of us being.
Reasons why I asked, man. I was watching and that's why I was trying to pull up while you were speaking, man.
Mm-hmm.
I was watching anti-racism activist. Her name is Jane Elliott.
Oh, yeah. My partner always sent me her little
And,
clips.
You know, she was talking about that. Black lives matter because for 500 years
right.
they didn't matter.
Right.
You know
right.
what I'm saying?
You gotta think, Mal, there has not been a decade in this country without a race war.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Like, period.
Right.
From the time we got here to
mm-hmm.
now, there's not been a decade without a race war.
Right.
So to say, in a race war against us, against
mm-hmm.
minorities,
right.
like, primarily us.
For sure. And you know what? I agree with what she was talking about, man. I watched the interview with her. She was on Hot 97.
Right.
Hiring nigga. But you know what I'm saying? I just thought it was dope. You know what I'm saying? Because I do feel like for sure all lives matter. Let's be clear, for sure. But Black lives matter. You know what I'm saying? That's not a racist statement. That's not to say anything about white people or anybody of any other whatever. It's that Black lives matter, man. Because unfortunately, in the eyes of the particular people that are killing us, it makes me feel like that we don't.
It's simple.
You know what I'm saying?
It's like this. For me, it's simple. In order to kind of divide a group, you kind of have to do that. Right. As the media, as a hierarchy, as a supremacist, you have to do that to say, all right, Black Lives Matter, but what about everybody else?
Right.
Like, and if y'all don't do that, then it's the only way you can separate and control.
For sure.
Like, that's just the way it works. It's systematic. Separate and control. Yeah, Black Lives Matter, but all lives matter too. They want to throw that out there. Right. And they try to separate the people within the black. That's why you see so many black people saying, well, all lives matter too. Which is cool.
Yeah.
Like, cool.
And that's the thing, like, the reason is, we never said ain't nobody else life matter.
For sure, right.
The reason they get like, it's the fact that you defensive make you look guilty. We never said y'all lives didn't matter. It's just,
man,
we the ones that need help right
for
now.
For sure. You know what I'm saying? Listen, man, and listen, all lives do matter. And I ain't gonna say no more about this, but we all know the real.
Right.
Like, we all know what it really feel like.
Definitely, man.
And for somebody to even say, well, all lives matter, over, it's just like, that's right. What's the point of you even saying that? Because all lives is all people right now not getting stopped by the police.
That is true.
Like, I'm gonna
talk about it, man.
You know what I mean?
Here,
I'm
man.
Driving through Park Place one day,
right?
And my Jag, I got a nice Jag, like it's matte black. You know what I mean? I'm driving through Park Place.
And when I tell you, look, I was telling my tights, man. When I tell my tights, we go to the club with Roy. I say, Roy, that boy parking space. Parking space.
Valet
shit. They gonna park my shit.
You talking about?
I mean,
I get followed.
Right.
By the police.
Yeah.
But you know what I mean? I peeped them. Like, I'm at the light. I'm right on 27th Street. You know what I mean? I'm going
north
down.
Virginia.
Yeah, north of VA. Yeah. You know what I mean? I'm on 27th Street. And I see him at the light. I peep him. I look at him like he look at me.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? I know for sure. Because this, right now, I see a black Jag in Park Place. You're not supposed to be here.
Right.
Don't worry. Let me get off.
That's crazy.
I pull off. You know what I mean?
Right.
He get like, he wait for two cars to come pull in behind. Like, man, he pulled me off. He pulled me over, like, right by my mama crib.
Wow.
Like, I pulled, you know what I mean? I made the left. I just stopped my car.
Right.
See him come around the corner. I already knew he was coming.
Right,
stopped the whip. I could have went to my crib.
Right.
Stopped the whip and sat there.
Right.
Here you go.
Crazy.
All my stuff good.
Right.
Like, he gave me a ticket. All right, bro, I'll pay your $40 ticket.
Right.
You mad.
Right.
You mad.
But it's
cool.
You know me, like, even being light skinned, growing up in the hood though, but even though they don't know my mama black,
right.
But they look at me and they just pass me because they don't know
my mama
black. You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
But then
man.
I see people like you. You know what I'm saying? He black. You could tell he black.
For sure.
You can't tell I'm black.
Right.
They'll pull him over before they pull me over.
That's crazy. Right. And you know what? It just shouldn't be that way.
I mean, no, I'm gonna tell you why, man. Another reason why, as a black man in America, we are the greatest threat to society.
Mm.
I'm gonna tell you why, because we got so much power that we don't even know we got. Mm. And that's the problem right there.
Preach.
Like, one, you can't, and that's the way to control us, by making us more violent or putting us in a certain box and categorizing us and saying this is the only way we can be. Like, you see on movies, you see on TV, is black men are a certain way. Like, we are the greatest threat at the end of the day. And being the greatest threat, they got to take all precautions. And the thing is, you know, a lot of people, I mean, just going throughout college, a lot of people say, well, you know, black on black crime, this, that, and the third. Cool, I get it. You put a group of people in a box, limit their resources, take everything from them, crime is going to happen.
Sure.
And the crime didn't start in the black neighborhood, it started in America.
Period.
So, we adopted certain things that America, you know what I mean, made normal.
Exactly.
But when we do it,
it's crazy.
And to the extent that it happens so much, is or black on black crime, then that kind of is another thing that nods at Black Lives Matter. Black lives really matter, then why black on black? That's easy to say, but if you're not looking at the systematic, you know what I mean, position, like you're not looking at the prison system.
When a black man kill a black man, that black man go to jail.
Like you're not looking.
White man kill a black man, that white man is just getting suspended from work and going back to his regular life.
Just to touch on what he said earlier, though, it's just like he said, you know what I'm saying? You put us in a box, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no way. How the fuck we go to Columbia and get coke? You know what I'm saying? How we get guns?
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying? That shit, it don't add up.
Right.
They put it there. You know what I'm saying? Cause they know what we gonna do with it.
Dang. Cali boys.
Yeah.
But I mean, honestly, it's the good thing about it is we got with that power that we do have. There's so much we can do. Like there's so much we can build. There's so much we need to own, and that's the thing we don't realize. Owning in this country is
power.
That's it. Own your, cause they can't take that from you.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And I'm slowly learning that. Is then that's the business side of it. That's what we don't learn in school.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we not learn. That's not, they not teaching that in K-12
for sure. Right.
And half of us not making it through 12. So
not teaching in college either.
They not teaching it in college unless you taking business courses.
Yeah.
They not teaching that.
Right.
Yeah, I mean,
definitely can never take away from the fact that Black lives matter, man. That our lives matter, man. Because unfortunately, through time, they just haven't been. You know what I'm saying? And I think a lot of people take this statement for a racist statement when people say Black lives matter or anything. And it's not even like that. Nah, like crazy. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Well, my thing is, I just hope we keep the intensity up. Cause you know what, they beat us down so much that we don't even know it. Far as what they even play on the radio, our attention span is so short.
Right.
It's crazy.
Right.
It's so crazy. Our attention span gone.
Right.
Now that's what I'm saying. If we can keep this intensity up without forgetting about tomorrow or them throwing another app like Pokemon Go in from distracting us, then you know what I'm saying?
Man, I really
be good.
I want to get into this. Look, please don't comment on this show.
Hold on, I got 30 Pokemon.
Please don't comment.
I know I just talk shit about it.
No. Please don't comment on this because our time is limited here, and I know this is something we can talk about all day, man. But, bro, it's so crazy that you mentioned that Pokemon because somebody was like, yo, that Pokemon shit is just a distraction.
I know it is.
But even crazy, though, and I'm not big on like conspiracy theories and things like that.
Like Illuminati.
But I'm watching like this Earth Simpsons joint, right? I'm watching this shit from The Simpsons, right? In the clip from The Simpsons, right?
Oh, they got Pokemon.
Hold on though. In the clip from The Simpsons, they got Trump at the podium as president on one of the shits. They got a 9 with 2 ones beside it.
Maybe
this before 9/11 happened. Then they got one of the characters from The Simpsons holding up a cell phone with a Pikachu in the cell phone looking for Pokemon.
Yeah, before it happened, right?
Bro, this shit correct. And like I said, I'm not big on like the conspiracy theories and all that kind of stuff.
All
but
that
like,
shit happened though.
That shit
all
crazy.
That shit
but anyway, from in my opinion, man, even being from Norfolk though, man. Shout out to my man in the building, man. Bro got a goddamn pipe. Look, the snake bit me. You know what I'm saying?
But nah, man.
You know, you come from, in my opinion, man, because a lot of people had a stigma on Norfolk, man. Like, you know, it's full of broken homes, or it's full of like, it is poverty driven. You know what I'm saying? We do have a lot of low income, and we do have a lot of homes or people that grow up in single parent homes or have certain situations to where, you know, it weighs a lot on them, so they not able to excel the way that they want to in certain things because of things that's going on in the home. And you want to speak on how, like, you know, growing up in your home, man, because you come from a very good background, man.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I want to say Roy, not only was Roy parents, his parents, but they was the neighborhood parents.
Yes.
You feel me? Like, you know, looking out for everybody in the neighborhood, man. And how did that play, you know, in your life, man, with everything that you got going on?
Man. Shout out to Bam and your mom.
Shout out to Bam.
The mom. Man, honestly, bro, it was just, for them, you know what I mean, they came up together. Like, they from the projects, you know what I mean?
Right.
Down they just they came up here together. Like my pops was big on family. Like I remember when I was legit, like little, he used to always tell me and my sisters, like, don't nothing come between y'all three.
That's right.
Like, don't nothing, cause for him, like his family weren't there. Like it was just him.
Right.
Like my, he got 6-7 brothers I ain't never met before.
Right,
brothers,
right.
Sisters, like I ain't never, you know what I mean?
Right.
And that's just how it is in his side of the family. So for him, he really big on just keeping everybody together. And him and my mom really just meshed like that. Like,
right.
Honestly, a lot of times it was just the house that Jack built. Everybody knew.
That's right.
Our crib on 27th Street. Like, you know what I mean? You come to our crib.
Yeah, right,
you can vibe. You can stay the night.
What?
We can have a party.
What?
We can do whatever. Like,
no,
that's our
crib. It ain't never been a negative vibe.
Like, you
off
always
type of energy
love.
At Roy crib.
Always,
like,
always love.
Man.
You know what I mean? That's just a testament to just my people's. Like, that's just how they are. Like, my pops and my mom's. Like, that's just, you know, their relationship.
Man.
And, you know, I'm just grateful, blessed
right.
to be able to have them two, you know what I mean? Be my parents.
So, look, man, we
right.
we opened up the interview today, man. I said, introducing battle rapper, man. Reynolds, man. Listen, man, like, even though you play football, man,
damn,
you know,
big
hip-hop head over here, man. Look, man, listen, for those that don't know, man, y'all might have seen a freestyle or two from Roy on Instagram. I got like 7 or 8 that I get to my phone personally.
Adam,
like, Mal,
hey,
you hear me, bro? You know what I'm saying? Like,
because they're going to be worth some money. I'm
look. So, listen, but listen, though, man. Like, it gets to the point where, like, I'm on Twitter, man. Holla. Even reached out.
Yeah.
Seen that he done seen a jump, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? What makes you feel like, man, I can rap, man? Like, what makes you love hip-hop or even want to rap like you've been doing?
I'm gonna grab the mic right quick. we was on 27th Street in Labyrinth Point. I'm walking down the block, I'm probably like in 6th grade. I spit some shit that Mal was like, oh, that shit don't make sense. I stopped rapping after that. I ain't spit another bar. All through here, hunters, I'm like, man, I knew I could spit. Mal took my confidence. You know what I mean? Killed me. So I'm like, I'm in the crib watching rap battles. Like, okay. nah, bro. It's just something fun to do. I like to write, man. You know what I mean? Like, I was, you know what I mean? Big on poetry and shit, niggas don't know. I like to write poetry, you feel me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so for me, battle rap is just an outlet, you know what I mean? I like to rap, I like to express myself.
Definitely,
you know,
man.
It's cool.
I wanted to ask you, man, because whenever I look at whenever I see the raps, man, they always a cappella, man. Like, would you, and I gotta ask, man, would you entertain a 1-round battle on
you
URL,
do that.
Man?
You always
like,
do that.
Would you, though?
You gonna write my round?
Unless you do a 1-round.
Yeah, I mean, for the fun.
For fun?
Because a lot of athletes like Kevin Durant, you know what I mean? He in the battle rap, you know what I mean? Seeing a lot. He got some things shaking.
Hey, Damian Lillard, man.
And yeah.
He's nice, man.
Yeah, yeah. I think, yeah, he dope.
He
I don't know if he can battle rap,
nah,
though.
I seen Sean.
I heard him freestyle before. I don't know if he can battle rap.
Oh, word.
Like, you know what I mean? It's technical in the beat.
It is.
Niggas can just rap, but for them, like, rappers and battles, two different, like, you know how it is, you know what I mean?
You
gotta have everything in the battle rap, like, to really do it. And I love battle rap, so.
Two questions, man. Top five
battle rappers.
No particular.
He better have been first.
Got it, man. K crazy.
I knew you was gonna ask me this, and I was like, I'm at the crib preparing, like, come on, it's so hard, because I mean, I don't want to put Clips in there, because I feel like he took back-to-back L's, and I'm tired of Clips a little bit, but his first Avery was... spectacular.
Hold on.
But anyways,
is A-Verb in your top five?
Who?
You say it's
A-Verb. No, not A-Verb. Okay, so
A-Verb in my top five. But go ahead.
Why is it so hard?
I mean,
who you? Okay.
You want to know mine?
Surf.
Okay.
I like Surf.
Alright.
New Generation Rock.
Who?
Tate Rock.
Yeah.
Just because.
Yeah, of course. Tay-Rock, I'm agreeing with
I'm
you.
I'm talking right now.
Yeah.
For right now.
He been turning up.
Who gonna be my fourth man? My fourth man will be Hitman Holla. Facts.
Did you just whisper that shit?
Yeah, he did.
Did you not edit that out?
There's so many like dudes that's nice. But the top of my fifth out, I'm gonna keep it all the way Norfolk. You feel me? You already know who going to my top five. The bar man. Cause listen, I mean, I seen the first battle with this man.
Oh, he had a school.
Like, and I'm like, bar after bar after bar after bar.
I was telling, if Av came to the show, like, and I was telling him, 10 people. I said, if Av keep doing what he do, I don't really see nobody sitting in front of that. Other than K, because K punch. That's it though.
When he punch, you feel it.
Only person that punch consistently like that is K. You know what I'm saying?
I hit that boy Lamar. I say, bro, listen. That boy Av is a problem.
And I told Av too, I said, listen, when he was battling in the town, he was good, don't get me wrong. Yeah. But it's a whole nother Av on that URL stage.
Problem. So yeah. I mean I like him in my top five.
Word, the only
way I say I don't like Clips in my top five is because one, I just heard he got killed by Nitty. Like slaughtered. I don't know, I didn't see it, but that's what I heard.
Unfortunately, I've heard the same thing.
Right. And me personally,
I heard he freestyled. First two rounds.
Right, and nobody got time for that.
Yep.
And me personally, I think he lost to Young Cannon, so
that's how I feel.
Young Cannon's a problem.
He is nasty. He is nasty.
Stupid. He was really barring Clips out, and nobody wanted to be like, oh, right. Clips took a L. I don't care what nobody said. Like, it was hype because, you know what I mean? It was Clips, but Cannon snapped. Like, he may slid off a little, but the whole time he was snapping.
He's top five rappers, man.
Period. No particular order.
No particular order. Right now. You a hip hop head, man. Right now. You know what I'm saying?
Throw it up.
Dot. K-Dot, for sure. Yeah, my top five. You love Drake. Drake makes good music. If I don't put him in my top five, it'd be controversial for now.
I got a DMX nigga hot.
Controversial.
Yeah, I mean,
I got a DMX hot.
Not Drake.
Complexion.
I'm a little. Anyway, I'm a slide off Drake. K-Dot. Mm-hmm. Kanye. Mm-hmm.
Jay. Big homie.
I'm gonna give the yay over Jay just cause.
No. Listen, right. That's the beauty about hip hop. Right. It's all opinionated.
Don't get me wrong.
Talk about it. It's all respect to Jay.
Break it down. Let me. Okay, this is what I'm saying.
Just talk about it.
As far as Jay, that's solidified.
Cool. Yeah.
Jay has lasted the test of time. We get it. But Yay.
It's right now.
Not even right now, but from Ye's done some unbelievable things.
Yeah, he has.
And to be in a position, like for me, I love the Pablo shit.
I did too. For like Pablo was crazy. We about to put flood in the room. Crazy.
It was crazy.
Crazy. You break down the music, the way he put it together.
Man, what?
Crazy.
It was stupid. And that's just, personal. It's personal. Don't get me wrong, Jay solidified.
Cool. I'm putting Ye up there.
Cool, okay, I'm putting Ye up there.
We gone.
Right now.
Fuck. Don't do that.
Listen, man, I'm going to tell y'all something. Y'all just...
He about to say bubble spot. So
I ain't gonna say that. And yeah, I mean, I'm diverse. I like a lot of music. I just love music. I love hip hop. Kodak Black. In my top five.
I'm talking about this year.
This year. Y'all gotta understand.
You got a Florida background.
I've been in a different place. I ain't been in Virginia. Like, I've been in Florida. I seen the way it impact the people. Like, you know what I mean? Being 17, 18 years old.
Right.
Like rapping about when they say bro really got off the porch and was really like he was really in
what's
the like,
what's
he
the
ain't rapping about nothing that he just made.
Listen, when I bet that bit that it's no hook. What's the shit where it ain't got no hook?
He just know how to ride the beat.
Huh? Yeah, listen, that shit ain't got no hook. You understand me? That's a just verse.
Yeah.
I watching footage, right? Everybody in the crowd know the words to this shit. I'm talking to the point where he cut it off and everybody rapping this shit. But listen though, it's not even a song though, it's a freestyle. It's no hook, it's just straight rap and then it go off.
And this is another reason. Cause you gotta think, when he wrote Institution, like niggas ain't heard, he was locked up at 17.
Right.
Like, listen to it. And when I say listen to it, listen to what he really saying.
Right.
Like, that's a lot of pain and hunger in that shit.
For sure.
Like, it ain't like I'm just saying, oh, that nigga hungry.
For sure.
Yeah. And this last shit he dropped, that shit was stupid.
Right.
Yeah. And you got Gucci and Boosie on your album.
Yeah.
Street Gods.
He remind me of like
name another nigga who do that.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
Like, my nigga from Broad County say, listen, this nigga the next Boosie. Like, they been saying that shit since he was a jit. So for me, it's just like, I just respect what he doing.
Yeah, I do
like, and
I like
if y'all don't believe me, go listen to Cell Therapy, Kodak Black Freestyle, and he murders that shit.
Yeah.
Only cause niggas don't understand when I say he know how to ride a beat, like he gonna finesse, like the beat just gonna
go with him.
Like, and you really blessed to do that.
You know what's great? He called himself a lyricist and niggas laugh, but
y'all like,
you can't even, exactly,
man,
you can't even,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Cause that's what he been through.
And people be that's thinking, like, in my opinion, people be putting lyricism on like how you rap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or how you put it together. And for me, lyricism is about how well you can relate to it, and what you talk about. You know what I mean?
I'm gonna tell you, I'm not gonna say he in my top 10 right now.
Who?
Yeah.
Cool that. He in my,
talking about, they don't understand.
Word.
He in my top 10 right now. Cool, whatever, I say top 10. I ain't gonna do all 10.
So you ain't gonna say top 5?
Nah, cause then I just thought about some more people, you feel me?
Well, listen, man,
I'm a different type.
Listen.
Hold on, I had a top 5 too.
Please, go ahead, Flood, DJ Flood.
I like 5. I like Jeezy. I like Fab, just cause Fab standing the test of time too, and a lot of niggas don't really.
I like Fab. Y'all be liking rappers for all reasons, you know what I'm saying? Like, not only can Fab rap to me though, but like, I like Fab. I think he get fly.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? I like his presence when
he perform. Chance in my top 5 too. I ain't mean to say that.
Chance though.
Chance the rapper in my top 5.
Chance though. Yeah. He made really good music, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Right now.
DJ Flash Flood. Who's your top?
Oh.
Now you said 5.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did. Kodak. Mm-hmm.
Nah, he said Kodak in his top 10.
Oh, right. So you got one more then?
Breeze.
Norfolk.
That's another conversation.
Not Breeze.
Rambo Breeze.
Not Breeze Barker.
Yeah,
Breeze.
And that's just because I got to. Yeah. That's really, I really believe that. Anyways.
DJ Flash Flood.
Right.
Top five.
No. We ain't talking about top five, right?
Top five. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, I love to just watch your progression, man, and everything that you got going on. Man. You know what I'm saying? Because I think it's dope, man. Like, not only to just watch it, man, but just to know that, like, you know, for my motivation, man, it's just like, yo, this somebody that I really used to hang out with every other day. You know what I'm saying? Like, Mount, what you doing? Come outside, and vice versa.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, really hanging out. Like,
right.
It's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? And for me, to see where you at right now, man, traveling, you know, city to city, man, on boats, new crib, all type of shit, man, family straight, giving back, man. That's my motivation, man, to know that, like, listen, man, if he set out here and he did those things, man, then, you know, I definitely can do the same things, man. So I appreciate you coming through the show, man. And again, man, I just think everything you're doing is dope, man.